That's a big one. Yeah.
Wow.
This is Centenary Rocks now, just a small outcrop. This is Centenary Rocks, 9:15 a.m, Saturday morning, overcast day with a bit of rain.
Lovely.
Yeah, just there. Yeah. The rest of it's been burned out. Little pine trees here. Crunchy daisies there too, I think.
When it was, a couple of years ago perhaps. Just noticing that the taller trees haven't actually, oh there's one that has, haven't been shooting from their epicormic shoots so much, so the farm must have been low.
Now we're driving a little bit south of west, miles of open heathland, left all the big gum trees. Sign?
Yes, in the box.
In the box?
Oh, I've signed it. I've left the message for the play by riders. But they choose
a
up
there. Oh, they just. The meeting of four ways here. And they. They're all the trail bike riders, they reckon that's their signature. To yeah, show which way to go.
Yeah, but there's a sign there pointing which way to go.
Right there's one of those Holland Track
markers, I mean. German tourists on their first four-wheel drive trip.
Don't touch this rock too much, the top of it.
Sun's just come out and we're winding through this lovely track. All these low trees, I reckon this is what the other would have looked like before the fire went through and killed it all off. Going down the vermin-proof fence. There's one in the distance. Very smart fence. Still going along the rabbit-proof fence. All the wildflowers. Sudden this lovely track comes to an end. Lovely fence comes to an end. Head off.
Yeah, funny.
Here's the vermin proof and here's the track. Just feeling sorry for all the little native animals that were cut off by the track, but all they have to do is walk around the edge.
This is the Sandalwood Rocks. Don't know where the sandalwood is. Might be all the burnt trees. There's 1K back down there is the Holland Track. Oh, that's some new flowers, little paper daisies in the bushes at the Sandalwood Rocks.
Yeah, I see all in there.
Yeah.
All amongst them. Yeah.
It's been very strong perfume through all the scrub. This is blowing it through the cabin. And a couple of new grevilleas. We saw this one several miles back, an hour back, and we never saw it again. Nice sandy little track, but you have to turn the steering wheel from left to right all the time.
Just after he said about the turning, the track straightened up a bit, but now we're back into a little bit more twisty turny. There's Anthony setting up for lunch.
We've been going south for several K now, wondering where we were going. Now we've hit some breakaways, a cliff. There's a, looks like laterite or granite, a lot of laterite country. Lots of geophys tracks all over, all the way down, crisscross with a network. Now the wind's just come up.
Now your map says that there'll be a signpost somewhere along the line that says Bounty Mine Private Access Road. So maybe it has to do with the mine.
Sorry, you're breaking up. I've just had to go up to the top of this hill, but there's a line of overhead electric cables. They do a right angle turn, and I suspect they go up that track where it said buried electrical cables, and I suspect.
West again now, and struck a power line that goes into us, into a must be a big mining area. Well, this is the intersection to the Southern Cross Road up there, and the HT track, which follows into the Bounty Mine, and there, that's the way we came out. And that's the part of the Holland Track, and you follow the power line. Here's a sign worth pinching.
Have a look for it from about 12 on.
We just left that main gravel road.
This is very chopped up, or has been. Bottoming out in places.
And left the Southern Cross Hyden Road, which went to the Bounty Mine. Now we're back on the Holland Track again, winding our way through the mallee on the sandy wandering track, watching out for tree roots and a mallee mound, mallee fowl nest.
You want me to just hold that?
In a pothole.
This bit looks a bit challenging. I'll walk through it and see what the car and the trailer do. Okay, here it comes. Ah, it's just going to go straight through the holes. Poor little trailer. See, it never looks as bad when you're filming it. Only looks bad before you approach.
Did they hear you, did they? Yeah. Another little thing to see on the way. The mallee fowl mound in memory of a guy. It's all well dug out, is it?
Well, I don't think that's very active. The other thing is that the...
Oh, we got to get on to Hyden now. Well, this is Wattle Rocks, and we found a first bunch of wattle brushes. It says Wattle Rock.
Found this little yellow bush that's very highly perfumed, and loads and loads and loads of tea tree all around it. That's the little yellow one, just past Wattle Rocks. 50 metres past, very highly perfumed. Just this is a stump in a tricky position. The car just went round it, but the trailer's not going to avoid it because the car's had to go the other way. So, oh whoops. Right, did him okay.
And we've got to pick out which
straight through the middle
which
of that one, do you reckon?
When you come to this second patch of rock, the two sort of distinct patches on the track here, almost at the foot.
Stuck a bit there.
Just checking this out before we come through it. Looked a bit tight on the left, but maybe that would have been a better idea. It's a bit of a climb out. Oh, they always look fiercer beforehand than afterwards. Now we'll see. These'll be
I can see for miles now. A flat plain climbing up high and round towards the mast. This is Native Rocks. Holland Track will start if you're going north to Coolgardie. Just 6 o'clock we reached it. Mary's been listening to the cricket somewhere, the Gabba. And this is the road that goes behind me to Hyden. That goes off somewhere else to the west. Goes to Norseman to the east. And we get down by this. The Granite and Woodlands Discovery Trail. And that's the road off to Norseman, which we were thinking of coming along. There's Smokey and the Sunset at the end of the track. It was a pretty good drive, good fun. Very rough and very badly abused by hoons in their four-wheel drives, unfortunately. Now we'll head into our camp at Hyden. Catch up with Anthony. There's a rabbit-proof fence that would have been 1,170 miles long or so. Goes up the Kalbarri.
Half the grid behind us is full of gravel, so
full of
they can walk across there.
And dogs and rabbits can get across the grid there. Well, this is the Wave Rock pool. Camped here last night. Just gonna check out the shop. Haven't been up the rock yet.
There's that Waltzing Matilda.
Oh, that's the one, is it?
Yeah, same one as
the little trolley from Woolworths. Mary remembers them. The Is that a copy of the horse in the silver?
Yeah, the original.
Looks like a Norman Lindsay up there. GW Scamps, it is. Scamps is Cardoon.
Oh, is it?
All the diggers, First World War, and the pyramid. Library. There's our old Ford Prefect. April 1965 was about the time after Ike. April May 65, Julie Andrews and Wave Rock.